Hello everyone, welcome back to Exams A to Z. This is Uma Maheshwar. In this video, we are going to cover trigonometry problems which are asked in Tier 1 2018. There are so many types of problems asked. I tried to segregate the problems, all the models at once. Then we'll discuss it in detail. Now, let's start. First, we look at the sums based on triplet. That's for a right angle triangle, and we'll see most commonly used triplet. We often see 1 plus p square, 1 minus p square, and 2p. So this is the most used triplet. This is the hypotenuse, and the other two are sides, side 1, side 2. If it is p square plus 1, then you can also say it as p square minus 1, 2p. If hypotenuse is 1 plus p square or p square plus 1, it can be 1 minus p square or else p square minus 1. This becomes 2p. This is the most commonly used triplet. So whenever they give you 2p and p square plus 1, the other side is 1 minus p square or p square minus 1. So just remember that. But remember one thing, 1 plus p square is a hypotenuse which is opposite to 90 degrees. So let's see some of the questions asked based on this triplet. Here sine theta is equals to p square minus 1 by p square plus 1. So sine theta is given as p square minus 1 by p square plus 1. We know sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse. This is p square minus 1. If it is theta, then hypotenuse is p square plus 1. We know the third side as 2p. So if I do cos theta, which is 2p by p square plus 1. That's simple. Now in this sum, same as the previous one, but they have given cos theta. Cos theta is 2p. If it is 90 degrees, if it is theta. Adjacent by hypotenuse. Again, hypotenuse is 1 plus p square. So take it as 1 minus p square. Therefore, now tan becomes, tan theta is opposite by adjacent. So we are taking opposite by adjacent. That is tan theta. Here in the sum, secant theta minus tan theta is equals to p. Then cosecant theta is equals to, we know secant square theta minus tan square theta is equals to 1, which means secant theta plus tan theta into secant theta minus tan theta is equals to 1. Secant theta plus tan theta is equals to 1 by secant theta minus tan theta. Therefore, we can say secant theta minus tan theta is equals to p. Secant theta plus tan theta is equals to 1 by p. So if you add it, it becomes 2 secant theta is equals to 1 by p plus p. So secant theta is equals to 1 plus p square by 2p. So you can say secant theta is hypotenuse by adjacent. So hypotenuse is 1 plus p square, adjacent is 2p. So we know this is 1 minus p square. Now he's asking you cosecant theta. Cosecant theta is hypotenuse by opposite, 1 minus p square. Here in this problem, assume let cos theta be x. Then the equation is 4 minus 2 into sine theta, sine square theta becomes 1 minus cos square theta. 1 minus x square minus 5x is equals to 0. You get 2x square minus 5x plus 2 is equals to 0. Now for this equation, roots are, you can simply say it is 2 comma 1 by 2. cos theta is equals to 2, cos theta is equals to 1 by 2. Cos theta can never be 2. So this you can eliminate. Now cos theta is equals to 1 by 2. Theta is in between 0 to 90. So therefore I can say theta is equals to 60 because cos 60 is 1 by 2 in between 0 to 90. Now sine 60 plus tan 60. Sine 60 is root 3 by 2. Tan 60 is root 3. Therefore, you can say 3 root 3 by 2. Here, if you assume cosecant theta as x, cot square theta becomes cosecant square theta minus 1, x square minus 1. So 12 into x square minus 1, 31x plus 32. So I can take it as 12x square minus 31x plus 20 is equals to 0. 12 into 20, 3 into 4 into 5 into 4. You can write it as 15 into 16. So take 12x square minus 6 minus 15x plus 20. So factorize it. 4x you common, 3x minus 4 minus 5, 3x minus 4. So x is equals to, you get 4 by 3, you get 5 by 4. X means cosecant theta. Cosecant theta is hypotenuse by opposite. So if it is 4 and 3, then it is under root of 4 square minus 3 square. 16 minus 9, which is root 7. So tan theta is equals to 3 by root 7. Rationalize the denominator. 3 root 7 by 7. So the only option which 3 root 7 by 7 is there in the first. Now if you do 5 by 4 also, hypotenuse is 5, 4 is opposite. Therefore adjacent becomes 3. So tan theta becomes 4 by 3. So the answer is 4 by 3, comma 3 root 7 by 7. Now here in this case, let secant theta is equals to x. If secant theta is equals to x, then tan theta or tan square theta becomes secant square theta minus 1, which is x square minus 1. So I can take x square minus 1 minus 3x plus 3 is equals to 0. X square minus 3x plus 2 is equals to 0. From this I can say roots are 1 comma 2. Secant theta is equals to 1. Secant theta is equals to 2. Secant theta is 1 when theta is equals to 0. Secant theta is 2 when theta is equals to 60 degrees. 0 you cannot accept because theta is in between 0 to 90 but not is equals to 0. So I can accept 60. Go with 60. Sine 60 is root 3 by 2. Cot 60 is 1 by root 3. So you can say 3 plus 2 by 2 root 3, which is 5 by 2 root 3. Multiply and divide it with root 3 and root 3. You get 5 root 3 by 6. If you take sine theta is equals to x, 3x is equals to 2 into 1 minus x square. So it becomes 2x square plus 3x minus 2 is equals to 0. X is equals to, which means sine theta is equals to minus 2 comma 1 by 2 you get. So minus 2 you cannot take it, 1 by 2 you can take it. For theta is equals to 30 degrees. When theta is 30, tan is 1 by root 3. So 1 by root 3 whole square is 1 by 3. 2 by root 3 whole square is 4 by 3. This is 2. 2 square is 4. So 5 by 3 minus 4 is equals to 5 minus 12 minus 7 by 3 is your answer. This one we have already solved. If you assume cos theta is equals to x, 2 into 1 minus x square is equals to 3x. So I can get 2x square plus 3x minus 2 is equals to 0. X is equals to, you get minus 2 comma 1 by 2. Minus 2 we cannot accept because 0 is in between, theta is in between 0 to 90. So cos theta is equals to 1 by 2 if and only if theta is equals to 60 degrees, because it is in between 0 to 90. In this problem, let cos theta be x. So if I assume cos theta as x, I can say x square minus 3x plus 2 is equals to 1 minus x square. X square comes here, 2x square minus 3x plus 1 is equals to 0. X is equals to roots are 1 comma 1 by 2 you get. 1 means cos 90, cos 0 is 1. Cos 0 is 1, but 0 you cannot accept. So cos 60 is 1 by 2. So theta becomes 60 degrees. If theta is 60 degrees, cosecant 60 is 2 by root 3. Cot 60 is 1 by root 3. So overall it becomes 8 by root 3. Multiply and divide it by root 3 and root 3. This becomes 8 root 3 by 3. 3 cos square a plus 7 sin square a is equals to 4. You can write 3 into cos square a as 1 minus sin square a. Plus 7 sin square a is equals to 4. 3 minus. Minus 3 sin square a plus 7 sin square a becomes 4 sin square a is equals to 4 means. Sin square a is equals to 1 by 4. Sin a is equals to 1 by 2. Sin a becomes 1 by 2 when a is 30 degrees. Or else you can draw it like this. If it is 1, then this is hypotenuse is 2. So this becomes root 3. Now you want cot a. Cot a is equals to adjacent by opposite. You can say a is equals to 30 degrees. Cot 30 is root 3. Yeah, look at this equation. Expression says 2 plus tan square theta plus cot square theta by secant theta cosecant theta. The best way to do this sum is theta is equals to put 45 degrees. So 2 plus tan 45 is 1, cot 45 is 1, root 2 into root 2. So it becomes 4 by 2. It's 2. Now put it in the options. This becomes 1. This becomes 1 by root 2 into 1 by root 2, 1 by 2. Root 2 into root 2, it is 2. This is 1. So you can say the answer is secant theta, cosecant theta. If you want to solve it, then solve in this manner. We can say 1 plus tan square theta is secant square theta. In the same manner, 1 plus cot square theta is cosecant square theta. So numerator becomes secant square theta plus cosecant square theta. Do it further. You can say 1 by cos square plus 1 by sine square. This becomes sine square theta plus cos square theta by sine square theta into cos square theta. So 1 by sine square theta cos square theta. This becomes secant square theta by cosecant square theta by secant theta cosecant theta. So this finally becomes secant theta cosecant theta. So you can solve it, or else you can put the value. It's up to you. Now this one, 1 plus tan square theta plus 1 plus tan square theta to the power of minus 1 means he want to say it as cot square theta. 1 plus tan square is secant square theta. 1 plus cot square is cosecant square theta. Remember, secant square theta plus cosecant square theta becomes secant square theta into cosecant square theta. We have solved already it in the previous sum. Now k is equals to secant square theta cosecant square theta. Root of k is equals to secant theta cosecant theta. Now this question, if you want to solve by substitution, put theta is equals to 45 again. This becomes root 2 square is 2, again root 2 square is 2 into 1 minus 1 by root 2 square is 1 by 2. So this becomes 2. 1 minus 1 by 2 is 1 by 2, so 1 by root 2. So this becomes root 2. Now look at which option gives you root 2. First option, substitute theta is equals to 45. This becomes root 2 into 2, 2 root 2. This becomes 1 by root 2 into 2. So this is root 2, possible option. Now this becomes 1 by root 2 into 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 root 2, no. Now this becomes root 2 into 1 by 2. So this is 1 by root 2. So answer is sine theta into secant square theta. If you want to solve without putting the value of theta, let's solve them individually. This becomes, we know, secant square theta means 1 by cos square plus 1 by sine square. So it becomes 1 by cos square into sine square. So this becomes cos theta, 1 by cos theta into sine theta. Now this one, you can write it as sine square by cos square minus sine square. If you common sine square, 1 minus cos square by cos square, which is sine to the power of 4 by cos square. If you do under root, then it becomes sine square by cos. So finally, 1 by cos into sine, sine square by cos, sine, sine cancel. You're left with sine by cos square. So sine theta, let it be sine theta. 1 by cos square is secant square theta. Here if you look at cos square theta is equals to 3 cot square theta minus cos square theta. Multiply and bring cos square theta here. It becomes 4 cos square theta is equals to 3 cot square. Cot, you can write it as cos square theta by sine square theta. So from this you say sine square theta is equals to 3 by 4. Sine theta is equals to root 3 by 2, which means theta is 60 degrees. Now you have 1 by 2 secant theta plus sine theta minus 1 to the power of minus 1. Secant 60 is 2. This is root 3 by 2. So this becomes 1 plus root 3 by 2 to the power of minus 1. 2 plus root 3 by 2 to the power of minus 1. This becomes 2 by 2 plus root 3. Rationalize the denominator. 2 minus root 3, 2 minus root 3. This becomes 2 into 2 minus root 3. This question is same as the previous one. If you look at the same thing, cos square theta is equals to 3 into cot square theta minus cos square theta. So if you solve it, you get sine square theta is equals to 3 by 4, which means sine theta is equals to root 3 by 2. Where you can say theta is equals to 60 degrees. If theta is 60 degrees, then this becomes 1 by root 3 plus this becomes 2 by root 3. Therefore, 3 by root 3, which is root 3. Now look at this expression. From this, if you take this expression, common sine theta from the numerator, common cos theta from the denominator. So if you common sine theta, only look at the inner one, it becomes 1 minus 2 sine square theta. Cos theta, if you common, 2 cos square theta minus 1. Look at the numerator, write it in terms of cos. 1 minus 2 into 1 minus cos square theta. So this becomes 2 cos square theta minus 1. Anyway, both of them are cos 2 theta only. So you can cancel this. It becomes tan theta. So if you put it here, tan square theta plus 1 gives you secant square theta. Now in this question, the value of theta when 3 cos theta plus sine theta is equals to 1. All you can do is you can substitute the values from the option. If I substitute 0, you can say cos 0 is 1, sine 0 is 0, it's not 1. If you can substitute 60 by 2 plus sine 60 is root 3 by 2, this is not 1. If you substitute 30, root 3 into root 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2, this becomes 2 but not is equals to 1. If you substitute 90 degrees, cos 90 is 0, so root 3 into 0 is 0, sine 90 is 1, so this becomes 1. So simply substitute the options. Now here, sine theta minus cos theta plus 1 by sine theta plus cos theta minus 1. So in these problems, don't unnecessarily solve it. Just try to put theta is equals to 45 degrees, which is best suitable here. Sin theta and cos theta get cancelled if 45 if I put it. So in the numerator, you'll be left with 1. In the denominator, 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2, 2 by root 2. So 2 by root 2 minus 1, which is root 2 minus 1. You know, 1 by root 2 minus 1 is nothing but root 2 plus 1, if you rationalize it. Now look at in the options. This becomes root 2, 1 by root 2. This becomes 1. If I put theta is equals to 45, this becomes root 2. This becomes root 2 plus 1. Now this becomes root 2 minus 1. So our answer is root 2 plus 1. So therefore, secant theta plus tan theta is our answer. If you want to solve without substitution, let's see how do we solve it. Take sine theta minus cos theta plus 1 as sine theta plus 1 minus cos theta by sine theta plus cos theta minus 1. Multiply it with sine theta plus cos theta plus 1 by sin theta plus cos theta plus 1. Now in the numerator it becomes sin theta plus 1 whole square minus cos square theta. In the denominator it becomes sin theta plus cos theta whole square minus 1. So numerator you can write it as sin square theta plus 1 plus 2 sin theta minus cos square theta by, in the denominator it becomes 1 plus 2 sin theta cos theta minus 1. Minus 1 plus 1 cancel. In the numerator you can write 1 minus cos square theta as sin square theta. Already you have 2 sin theta, so write as 2 sin theta plus 2 sin square theta by 2 sin theta cos theta. 2 you cancel it. So it becomes sin theta by sin theta cos theta plus sin square theta by sin theta cos theta. Sin cancel, sin cancel. You left with 1 by cos theta, which is secant theta, plus sin theta by cos theta, which is tan theta. So this is how we solve without substituting the value for theta. Now look at this question. A is equals to 2 sin t, 2 sin x by 1 plus sin x cos x, 1 plus sin x plus cos x, and B is equals to C by 1 plus sin x. A is equals to B if C is equals to what? So if I equate A is equals to B, I'll get C is equals to, this 1 plus sin x goes up, 2 sin x by 1 plus sin x by 1 plus sin x plus cos x. Put theta is equals to 30 degrees. sin becomes 1 by 2, cos becomes root 3 by 2. We substitute 1 plus 1 by 2, 3 by 2. This becomes 3 by 2 plus root 3 by 2. 3 by 3 plus root 3. Multiply it with 3 minus root 3 by 3 minus root 3. It becomes 3 minus root 3 by 2. Now put it in the options. 1 minus root 3 by 4. This is not your answer. 1 plus 1 by 2 is 3 by 2. 3 by 2 minus root 3 by 2. So 3 minus root 3 by 2. So second one, possible option. Now this becomes 1 plus 1 by 2 root 3 by 2. It becomes root 3 by 4. So it becomes 4 plus root 3 by 4. Not your answer. Now this becomes 1 plus root 3 by 2 minus 1 by 2. So it becomes root 3 by 2 minus 1 by 2. Which is root 3 minus 1 by 2. This is also not your answer. So by substitution also you can find. Or else. You have to solve it. Now how do we solve it? Let's say C is equals to 2 sine theta 1 plus sine theta by sine theta plus cos theta plus 1. If you multiply it with sine plus cos minus 1, sine plus cos minus 1, in the denominator you get, in the numerator it is 2 sine 1 plus sine, sine plus cos minus 1. In the denominator you get sine square theta plus cos square theta, or sine theta plus cos theta whole square minus 1 square. So overall this becomes 1 plus 2 sine cos minus 1. So minus 1 plus 1 cancel. It becomes 2 sine cos. 2 sine and 2 sine cancel. Now numerator you multiply. Sine plus cos minus 1. Sine square plus sine c. Sine cos minus sine. Minus sine plus sine cancel by cos. You can write sine square theta minus 1 as minus cos square theta. So finally, c plus sc minus c square by c. C you cancel, you get 1 plus sine theta minus cos theta. So anyway, you can do it. 1 by sine theta minus cot square theta by 1 plus cosecant theta. We know cosecant square theta minus 1 is equals to cot square theta. So simply write down cosecant square theta minus 1 here. You can write it as cosecant theta plus 1 into cosecant theta minus 1 by 1 plus cosecant theta. This cancel. 1 by sine theta is nothing but cosecant theta minus cosecant theta plus 1, which is equals to 1. Now, in this question, you common cos. If I common cos theta, take the LCM 1 minus sine plus 1 plus sine. In the denominator, 1 minus sine square is equals to 4. So you get 2c by c square is equals to 4, which means c is equals to 1 by 2. Cos theta is 1 by 2 and theta is equals to 60 degrees. 60 means this becomes root 3 plus 2 by root 3. So 5 by root 3 is equals to, multiply it with root 3 and divide it by root 3. So 5 root 3 by 3 is your answer. One by one plus sine square theta plus one by one plus one by sine square theta. So if you simplify this one, 1 by 1 plus sine square theta plus sine square theta by 1 plus sine square theta. If you do it, denominator is anyway same, 1 plus sine square theta. Numerator also becomes 1 plus sine square theta. So it becomes 1. In this problem, tan theta by 1 minus cot theta plus cot theta by 1 minus tan theta is equals to 1 plus k, then k is equals to. So substitution is also not so easy. If you want, you can substitute theta is equals to 30 or 60, but not 45. Because what happens when you substitute 45? If you substitute 45, it becomes, denominator becomes 0. So you can't substitute 45. You can go with theta is equals to 30 or 60. Or else, try to solve in this manner. Write down tan theta as sine by cos. So I'm taking this as sine by cos. 1 minus cos by sine plus cos by sine 1 minus sine by cos. So this becomes sine square by cos into sine minus cos. This becomes cos square by sine into, if I want cos minus sine, I'll get cos minus sine. But if I take common of minus, this becomes sine minus cos. Take the LCM, then you will get cos sine sine minus cos sine cube minus cos cube. A cube minus B cube is A minus B into A square plus B square plus AB by sine cos sine minus cos. Simply you cancel sine square theta plus cos square theta is anyway 1. 1 plus sine cos by sine cos. So 1 by sine cos becomes cosecant, cosecant and secant plus 1. So k value is cosecant theta, secant theta. 1 by cosecant theta minus 1 plus 1 by cosecant theta plus 1 is equals to 2 secant theta. Now, as we did it earlier, do it like 1 by 1 by sine minus 1 plus 1 by 1 by sine plus 1 is equals to 2 by cos. So this becomes sine by 1 minus sine plus sine by 1 plus sine is equals to 2 by cos. Sine you common, you get 2 by 1 minus sine square theta, that is cos square theta, is equals to 2 by cos. Cos, cos, you cancel. 2, 2 also cancel. So tan theta is equals to 1. Tan theta becomes 1 when theta is equals to 45 in between 0 to 90. So cot 45 is 1. This is 1 by root 2. Rationalize the denominator. This becomes root 2 by 2. So finally, it's 2 plus root 2 by 2. Now here in this, 1 by secant x minus tan x minus 1 by cos x. You can put x is equals to 45 degrees, but the problem is in the options, tan 45 is also 1, cot 45 is also 1. So when you are putting some value, make sure that your answers are different. So you'll get your answers as different when x is equals to 60 degrees. When x is 60 degrees, 1 by secant x is 2, tan x is root 3, because tan 60 is root 3, minus 1 by 1 by 2 becomes 2. This becomes 1 by 2 minus root 3 is 2 plus root 3, minus 2, which is root 3. From the options, 2 into 2, I can say 4. Now tan becomes tan x, tan 60 is root 3, 2 into cos 60 is 2 into 1 by 2 is 1. Now here you have cot 60, cot 60 is 1 by root 3. So your answer is tan theta. If you don't want to substitute, if you want to solve it, you can also solve it. You can write as 1 by cos minus sine by cos. First I'm solving this. You can write it as cos by 1 minus sine. Multiply it with 1 plus sine by 1 plus sine. It becomes cos into 1 plus sine by cos square theta. So you are left with 1 plus sine by cos. And you have minus 1 by cos. So cos you common. 1 plus sine minus 1. Minus 1 plus 1 cancel. Sine theta by cos theta is tan theta. Like this also you can solve it. tan theta minus secant theta plus 1 by tan theta plus secant theta minus 1 into secant theta is equals to 1 by k. Then he's asking you k value. If I substitute theta is equals to 45, the problem with 45 is sine 45 is same as cos 45. So both of them are same. 1 minus cos theta, 1 minus sine theta, both of them will be same. So in order to differentiate your options, we can simply substitute theta is equals to 30 or 60. But I go with theta is equals to 60 because it will be easy for us to substitute. Tan 60 is root 3. Tan becomes root 3. Secant becomes 2. Now tell me what is k here is. It goes reciprocated. Tan theta plus secant theta minus 1 by tan theta minus secant theta plus 1 into 1 by secant theta is cos theta. So substitute here, root 3 plus 2 minus 1 is plus 1. Root 3 minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1 into 1 by 2 here. Divide and multiply it by root 3 plus 1 by root 3 plus 1. In the numerator, it becomes root 3 plus 1 whole square. In the denominator, it becomes 4. So root 3 plus 1 whole square is 4 plus 2 root 3 by 4. So it is 1 plus root 3 by 2. 1 plus root 3 by 2 is 1 is 1 only. Root 3 by 2, you can write it as sine 60, which means sine theta. So the answer is 1 plus sine theta. And same thing if you want to do it without substitution. First, write down the value of k. K is 1 by secant is cos. This becomes reverse. Tan minus secant minus 1. Tan plus secant minus 1 by this you can write it as 1, take the common of minus, secant minus tan. Why? Because you can write secant minus tan is equals to 1 by secant plus tan. So k is equals to c into tan plus secant minus 1. This you can write it as 1 minus 1 by secant plus tan. Tan plus secant minus 1 by secant plus tan minus 1 by secant plus tan. So this get cancelled. Finally, you're left with cos theta into secant theta plus tan theta. Cos into secant cancels, so it becomes 1. Cos into tan theta becomes sine theta. So answer is 1 plus sine theta. If sine theta is equals to 4 cos theta, you can say sine by cos is equals to 4, which means tan theta is equals to 4. 4 by 1 means 4, 1. So hypotenuse becomes root of 17. Now sine becomes 4 in 4 by root 17, cos becomes 1 by root 17. Sine theta into cos theta becomes 4 by 17. Simple right angle triangle, you can do it. Then find, use the Pythagoras rule and get the hypotenuse and substitute. Tan theta is equals to 2 by 3. So he's asking you, 3 sine theta minus 4 cos theta by 3 sine theta plus 4 cos theta. You can take common of cos theta, so it becomes 3 tan theta minus 4 by 3 tan theta plus 4. If you take common of cos theta and cos theta, or else if you divide it by cos theta and cos theta. Now substitute tan theta in this. So you'll get 2 minus 4 by 2 plus 4. 3, 3 anyway cancels. Minus 2 by 6 minus 1 by 3. Or else tan is equals to sine by cos, which is 2 by 3. So 3s minus 4 by 3s plus 4c. You can directly substitute 2 in place of sine, 3 in place of cos. Because it's a homogeneous expression, you can substitute it. If you have a single expression like 3s minus 4c, you can't substitute. but it's a homogeneous expression, so you can substitute it because numerator and denominator possess the same degree, so we can do that. Same as the previous one, you can say tan theta equal to 3 by 4 or 4 tan theta is equals to 3. Common cos theta from the numerator and denominator, it becomes 4 tan theta minus 1 by 4 tan theta plus 1. 4 tan theta is 3, so I can say 3 minus 1 by 3 plus 1, which is 2 by 4, 1 by 2 here. From this expression, from the numerator and denominator, if I common secant square theta. If you common secant square theta from the numerator and secant square theta from the denominator, then you get secant by cosecant by secant is cot square. You get cot square theta minus 1 by cot square theta plus 1. Cot square theta gives you 7 minus 1 by 7 plus 1, which is equals to 6 by 8, 3 by 4. Sine by cos from this is 2 by 3. Anyway, it's a homogeneous, so substitute. 4 into 2 minus 3. 4 into 3 plus 2. In place of sine, I'm substituting 2. In place of cos, you're substituting 3. So it becomes 8 minus 3, 5. 12 plus 2, 14. So it becomes 5 by 14. Again, in this question also, it is homogeneous. So you can say sine by cos. Sine by cos is equals to 5 by 2. So I can say 5 plus 2 by 5 minus 2 is equals to 7 by 3. Sine theta is equals to a by under root of a square plus b square. So we know sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse. Adjacent is B, if it is theta. Is asking secant theta plus tan theta. Secant theta is nothing but 1 by cos. Tan means sine by cos. It is nothing but 1 plus sine by cos. So 1 plus sine is A by under root of A square plus B square. Cos is B by under root of A square plus B square. So it is under root of a square plus b square plus a by under root of a. So this you can cancel anyway. By b you can say. So answer is under root of a square plus b square plus a by b. Cosecant theta is equals to 13 by 12 means cosecant is hypotenuse by opposite. Therefore, adjacent becomes 5, 12, 13, right? That's a triplet. So it is 5. Now, sine theta opposite by hypotenuse, 12 by 13. Cos theta adjacent by hypotenuse, 5 by 13. Tan theta is 12 by 5. Take the LCM, 65. 12 plus 5, 17. 17, 5 is 85. 12, 13 is 156. Therefore, we're left with minus 71 by 65. That's your answer. Even if you get it as negative, there is only one negative value. Cot theta is equals to 3 by 4. Usually, cot theta is adjacent by opposite. So, adjacent by opposite. Adjacent is 3. This is 4, 5. Sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse 4 by 5. Cos theta adjacent by hypotenuse 3 by 5. Tan theta is 4 by 3. This becomes 7 by 5 minus 4 by 3. So 21 minus 20 by 15. So answer is 1 by 15. Secant theta is 13 by 5. Just now we have seen a similar question. Secant is adjacent by hypotenuse by adjacent. So hypotenuse is 13, adjacent is 5, opposite is 12. Tan theta is 12 by 5 minus sine theta. Sine theta is 12 by 13. Cos theta is 5 by 13. So 12 by 5 minus
7/13. Take the LCM, this becomes 65. 156 minus 35. 156 minus 35 is 121 by 65. So that's the answer here. Again, the same question. Cos theta is 4/5. Cos means adjacent by hypotenuse. This becomes 3. Now, sine square theta is 3/5 whole square. 3/5 whole square. So simply you common sine theta cos theta here. It becomes sine theta plus cos theta. So I can say 3/5 into 4/5 by 3/5 plus 4/5. 12/25 into 7/5. 12 7s are 84 by 125. 3 sine theta is equals to 4 cos theta, which means tan theta is equals to 4/3. If tan theta is 4/3, 4, 3, hypotenuse becomes 5. Tan square theta is 16/9. Sine theta, opposite by hypotenuse, minus cos theta, 3/5. So 16/9, this becomes 1/5. So 80 plus 9/45. 89/45. 2 tan 30 by 1 minus tan square 30. It is in the form of 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta, which is actually tan 2 theta, which is tan 60, which is root 3. So it's like a direct formula, you can put it. Sin square 38 plus sin square 52 plus sin square 30 minus tan square 45. Sin square A plus sin square B is equals to 1 if A plus B is equals to 90 degrees. So we can go for it. Suppose this is 90. So therefore sin square A plus sin square B becomes 1 here. Tan 45 is 1. So this and this get cancelled. Sine 30 is 1/2. 1/2 whole square is 1/4. The value of sine square 60, cos square 45, secant 60 plus cos square 40 plus cos square 50. Cos square A plus cos square B is equals to 1 if A plus B is equals to 90 degrees. Therefore, I can say this is 90 degrees, 40 plus 50, this is 1. Sin square 60 is root 3/2 whole square, 3/4. 1/√2. 1/√2 is cos 45, so 1/√2 whole square is 1/2. This is secant 60 is 2. So overall, take the LCM of 4. 3 minus 2 plus 8. It becomes. And again, plus 1 we have. So plus 4. 12 minus 2, 10. 10 plus 3, 13. 13/4. In this question, cot square 62 can be written as tan square 60. 90 minus 62 is 28. Secant square 28 minus tan square 28 becomes 1. Sine 60 is root 3/2. Whole square becomes 3/4. Cosecant 30 is 2. 2 square is 4. So take the 4 as LCM, 3 plus 5 4s are 20. So here it is 23/4, 4 plus 1, 5. I'm just skipping one step, that's all. 3/4 plus 5, so it becomes 3 plus 20/4, which is 23/4. Secant square 29, cot square 61, you can write it as tan square 29. In the previous problem, it is 28. Now it is 29. That's all the difference is. Secant square minus tan square is 1. Sine square 60. Sine 60 is 3/√3/2. Sine square 60 is 3/4. Cosecant square 30 is 2. So 2 square is 4. Take the LCM 4. Now 5. You can write as 5 plus 3/4. We have already seen this sum. 23/4 it is. Again, same as the previous one. Here cot square 62, you can write it as tan square 28 minus secant square 28. It is in the reverse order, so it becomes minus 1. Cosecant square 30 is 2. 2 square is 4. Tan square 60. Tan 60 is root 3. Tan square 60 is 3. So minus 1 plus 7 is equals to 6. Sin square A plus sin square B is equals to 1 when A plus B equal to 90, we have seen. So this becomes 1. Tan 60 is root 3. So tan square 60 is 3. Cosecant 30 is actually 2. So 4 minus 2 is 2. Sin square A plus sin square B becomes 1 when A plus B is equals to 90. Tan 45 is 1. 1 square is also 1. Secant 60 is 2. So 1, 1 cancel. Answer is 2 here. This question, sin square A plus sin square B is equals to 1 if A plus B is equals to 90 degrees. So this becomes 1. Secant square 30 is 2 by root 3. 2 by root 3 whole square becomes 4 by 3. Plus tan 60 becomes root 3. Tan 60 whole square is 3. So I can say 4 minus 4 by 3. 12 minus 4, 8. 8 by 3. We know if A plus B is equals to 90, sin A is equals to cos B. And you can also say sin A by cos B is equals to 1. So sin A by cos B, where A plus B is 90, therefore it becomes 1. Sin 60 is root 3 by 2, sin square 60 is 3 by 4. Cos 45 is 1 by root 2, so it becomes 1 by 2. Secant 60 is 2. So 1 plus 2 is 3. Plus 3 by 4 minus 1 by 2. Take the LCM as 4. This becomes 12 plus 3 minus 2. Overall, 13 by 4. We know sin square A plus sin square B is equals to 1 when A plus B is 90. 90 here, 90 here. So this becomes 1 plus sin square 61. And you can write sin 29 as cos 61. This becomes cos square 61. We know sin square theta plus cos square theta is also 1. So finally 1 plus 1 is 2 here. Secant 4 theta is equals to cosecant theta plus 20 degrees, then theta is equals to. So whenever we have secant A is equals to cosecant B, we say A plus B is equals to 90 degrees. So simply 5 theta plus 20 degrees is equals to 90. 5 theta is equals to 70 degrees. Theta is equals to 14. Tan A is equals to cot B. Then you can say A plus B is equals to 90 degrees. So 4 theta plus 2 theta plus 30 is equals to 90. 6 theta is equals to 60. Theta is equals to 10. We know if sin A is equals to cos B, then you can say A plus B is equals to 90 degrees. So you can say theta plus theta. 2 theta plus 50 is equals to 90. So 2 theta is equals to 40 degrees. Therefore, theta is equals to 20 degrees. We know when sin A is equals to cos B, we say A plus B is equals to 90 degrees. So A plus B here is 5 theta minus 3 theta is 2 theta plus 50 is equals to 90. Therefore, 2 theta is equals to 40, theta is equals to 20 degrees. Now here by looking at it, you can say 2 theta plus 40 is 90, 2 theta equal to 50, theta is equals to 25 degrees. These are all given in the shifts. 5 theta plus 20 is equals to 90. 5 theta is equals to 70. Theta is equals to 14 degrees. When tan A is equals to cot B, we can say A plus B is equals to 90. So 3x plus 45 is equals to 90. 3x is equals to 45 degrees. X is equals to 15 degrees. Tan theta plus sin theta by tan theta minus sin theta is equals to k plus 1 by k minus 1. So all you can do here is, it is in the form of a plus b by a minus b is equals to c plus d by c minus d. If you apply component and dividend of this becomes a by b is equals to c by d. So I'm doing the same. Tan theta by sin theta is equals to k by 1. Tan theta means sine by cos. Already sine is there. Sine, sine get cancels. 1 by cos means secant theta. So we have applied componendo and dividendo. So if you apply componendo and dividendo to this format, then it converts to this. If you apply it to this format, then it will be converted like this. So very simple formula. Direct answer you will get. For more videos, subscribe to Exam A to Z.